Okay, so please try to understand the first method of your unconventional machining, that is the electrical discharge machining. Okay, first up on I will explain here the construction of that electrical discharge machining. Okay, also that electrical discharge machining, also it is called as the EDM. What is the long form of that EDM? Electrical discharge machining. Okay. Okay, now see the construction. Okay, please see here. First upon here, I will explain the construction, then I will explain the their working principle. Okay, first upon see the construction. In that electrical discharge machining, it consists of the one, the tank. The tank, it will act as the reservoir. Inside that tank, okay, inside that tank we are, here we are using the that dielectrical fluid. Okay, that dielectrical fluid. And that dielectrical fluid, here we can use the dielectrical fluid as the transformer oil, okay, or also we can use the lubricating oil, also we can use the kerosene, also we can use the distilled water. Okay, but for this electrical discharge machining, that point you have to remember, for that electrical discharge machining, here we can use the dielectrical fluid as the kerosene. Okay, dielectrical fluid we can use as the kerosene is used as the dielectrical fluid for this electrical discharge machining. Okay, now again we are using the workpiece. On that workpiece we want to perform the machining operation. That workpiece is also submerged into this dielectrical fluid, and also we are using one rod as a tool, and that rod, it will made up from the copper, brass or aluminum, and that rod we are using as the tool. And here in that electrical discharge machining, the workpiece and that rod both are submerged into this dielectrical fluid. Okay, here you have to remember we are using the kerosene as the dielectrical fluid. Okay, and inside that dielectrical fluid we have put the workpiece and tool, and in between that tool and workpiece we have maintained the small amount of the gap. See, the small amount of the gap we want to maintain here, and that small amount of the gap, it will be vary from 0.01 mm, 0.01 mm to the 0.5 mm. Okay, that much amount of the gap we can vary. Okay, that much amount of the gap we can maintain in between this workpiece and this tool. Then again, here we are using one power supply unit. Okay, for example, suppose we are using here one battery. Okay, and the supply, it will be the DC supply. Okay, and now again we are knowing that that battery, it having the two terminals are there. Okay, on that battery there will be one positive terminal will be there and one negative terminal will be there. But in this electrical discharge machining, what will be the connection here? The positive terminal of your battery is connected to the your workpiece, and the negative terminal of your battery is connected your tool. And we are knowing that that positive terminal we can call it is the anode. Okay, and that negative terminal we can call it is the cathode. Means your tool, it will act as the, here I am going to write here, your tool is going to act as cathode, means it having negative charge. Okay, and your workpiece is going to act as your anode. Okay, act as the anode. Okay, this is the basic construction. Which point you have to remember in that construction? We are using the dielectrical fluid inside this tank, and that dielectrical fluid, it will be the kerosene. Okay, and that workpiece and tool both are submerged into this dielectrical fluid. Okay, and here we are using the DC supply. The positive terminal of the battery is connected to the workpiece, the negative terminal of your battery is connected to the tool, so that your tool is act as the cathode and your workpiece is act as the anode, and the small amount of the gap is maintained in between the tool and workpiece, and this gap, it will be vary from 0.01 mm to the 0.5 mm. Okay, okay, now see here, this is the basic construction. Now see the working principle, how the metal is going to remove with the help of this EDM. Okay, again it is very simple. Now see the principle. See the principle, when we are giving the supply, okay, when we are giving the supply, that time what will happen? The small amount of spark is generated. Okay, when we are that supply, we are making the on, that time the spark is generated in between this two line workpiece. Okay, in between the two line workpiece, the spark is produced, and when this spark is come in contact with this dielectrical fluid, when this spark is come in contact with the dielectrical fluid, that time this dielectrical fluid is going to ionized, is going to ionized, and because of that, what will happen? Because of this ionization process, this dielectrical fluid, it will allow to flow the current. Okay, it will allow to flow the current, and because of this current, what will happen? Because of this current, the large amount of temperature is generated in between the spark gap. Okay, this portion is called as the spark gap. This portion is called as the spark gap. Okay, and in between the spark gap, due to that current, the large amount of temperature it will be generated. Okay, and this temperature, it will be ranged from 10,000 degrees Celsius to the 12,000 degrees Celsius. That much amount of temperature is generated in between the spark gap, and because of that temperature, your workpiece is going to melt. Okay, your workpiece is going to melt, means in this manner we can remove the material from your workpiece. Okay, this is called as the electrical discharge machining. See, this is the basic principle. This is the basic principle. On this principle, your EDM is going to work. Okay, now if you are not understood this ionization process, for the ionization process I am separately explain here. This is the ionization process. Means what is the use of this ionization process? When this spark, when we are giving the supply, that time the small amount of number of spark it will be generated in between this gap, and this when this spark is come in contact with this dielectrical fluid, and here we are using the kerosene as the dielectrical fluid, means when this spark is come in contact with your kerosene, that time this dielectrical fluid is going to ionized. Okay, means that dielectrical fluid, you have to remember here, the dielectrical fluid, it will act as the two function. Okay, or it will position, the two functions are there. Okay, what are their basic two function? The dielectrical fluid, it will first upon, okay, initially it will act as the insulator. What does it mean by the insulator? Insulator means there will not be flop current. Okay, insulator means there is no flop current. Okay, means initially this dielectrical fluid, it will act as the insulator, and then when the particular breakdown voltage, okay, particular voltage is reached, at that time this dielectrical fluid, it will act as the conductor. Okay, it will act as the conductor, means initially your dielectrical fluid, it will be insulator, and when amount of, okay, the required amount of voltage is generated, that time this dielectrical fluid, it will act as the conductor. Okay, and when it will become the conductor, that time only it will flow the current. Okay, and for this process, for the dielectrical fluid, we want to make a conductor for this process. Okay, or for this purpose, we want to perform the ionization process. Okay, this is the purpose of your ionization process. When the ionization process is completed, okay, when the ionization process is completed, and then and then only current it will be flow. So that it is important, that ionization process. Okay, if the ionization process is not take place, means your current is not going to flow. If any your current is not flowing, means temperature is not generated, means your workpiece is not remove the material like this. Okay, for this purpose you have to remember the ionization process is important in this year. Okay, then what is meant by that ionization process, I will tell you here. You have to remember, okay, this is for only ionization process. Now see here, this is the tool is here. Okay, and this is the workpiece is there. For the tool we have attached a, okay, for the tool we have given the negative terminal, or negative terminal is attached to the tool, and the positive terminal is attached to the workpiece. Okay, means when giving the supply to this tool and this workpiece, that time what will happen? Due to that negative charge, or due to that negative charge is given to that tool, due to that, this tool, that tool material, okay, we are knowing that that tool material, it will be the brass, copper or aluminium. This tool material, it will emit the electrons, electron having the negative charge. Okay, that tool, it will be emit the electron. For example, you have to remember only the, when we are giving the supply,
when we are giving the
supply, that time what will happen? This tool, it will emit the electrons. Okay. Now, the whatever electrons it is emitted by this tool, that electron is coming contact with the particle of your dielectrical fluid. See, this is the electron. This electron, it is emitted by this tool. Okay. Now, and also we are giving the positive supply to this workpiece, and that workpiece also it will be produce the metallic ions. See, this is the metallic ions. That metallic ions, it will be flow through the flow toward the tool, and this electron is flow toward this workpiece.
Okay. Now, when next point, when this electron is come in contact with the dielectrical fluid particle. Okay, we are knowing that, see, this is the dielectrical fluid is there, and inside that dielectrical fluid, small amount of particles are there. Okay, now, see here, this electron is combined with this dielectrical fluid particle. That time, what will happen? Ionization process is completed, and what will happen? It will means the dielectrical fluid also, it will emit the electrons. It will liberate the electrons. See here, this electron means this black color electron. Okay, for example, you have to understand this black color electron is coming from this tool, and when this electron is combined with this dielectrical fluid, that time ionization processes take place, and because of that ionization process, this dielectrical fluid particle, it will emit the electrons. It will liberate the electrons. Means the electron is coming from this tool, and also electron is coming from this dielectrical fluid, and because of that, what will happen? The envelope of electron, mean large amount of electrons are generated. Okay, the large amount of, see, this is called as the envelope, means, or in another language also we can say the large amount of electrons are generated in between the tool and workpiece, and because of that electron, what will happen? The current is going to flow. Okay, see, this is called as the ionization process. See, this is the simple ionization process. Okay, that point, so that I'm going to tell you here ionization process. Okay, now it is understood. Okay, once again, when we are giving the supply, that time what will happen? Spark is generated in between the workpiece and tool, and that spark, it will come in contact with the dielectrical fluid. That time what will happen? This dielectrical fluid is going to ionize it, and when it is going to ionize it, that time only this dielectrical fluid, it will flow the current. And when it will flow the current, that time what will happen? Large amount of temperature is generated, and that temperature range, it will be the 10,000 degrees Celsius to the 12,000 degrees Celsius, and because of that temperature, your workpiece is going to melt, means it will remove the material. Okay, this is the simple working principle. Okay, if you are not understood this, there is no problem, but only that point you have to remember. Supply, spark is generate, spark is coming in contact with dielectrical fluid, dielectrical fluid is going to ionize, and when it is ionized, that dielectrical fluid, it will be flow the current. When current is flow, temperature goes on increasing. Up to what range the temperature is increased? Up to the 10,000 degree to the 12,000 degree. That much amount of temperature is going to generate it. Okay. And due to that, your metal is going to work. Sorry, metal is going to remove. Okay. If so, anybody having any questions regarding to that? Such type of the question. If anybody having the one question, it will be there. If you are understood carefully, if anybody having the question like this, suppose here I have told here in that electrical discharge machining, we are using the kerosene as the dielectrical fluid. Okay, kerosene. Okay, this is the kerosene. And when we are giving the supply, and when spark is generated, means the large amount of temperature is generated. Okay, that time that kerosene, why that kerosene is not burn? Yes. Why there is not burn the kerosene? Yes, anybody?
Oxygen.
Yes. Why that kerosene is not burn?
Oxygen nasalamudu sir, kerosene burn.
Yes.
Oxygen nasalamudu.
Or why is not coming?
Hello sir.
Hello. Why the kerosene is not burn here? Because the whatever temperature are generated. Okay, whatever the temperature are generated in between the this gap, that temperature are only used to remove or to melt the workpiece. Okay, suppose here, for example, suppose the 10,000 degree. Okay,
10,000 degree amount of temperature is generated. Okay, out of that temperature, out of that temperature, suppose we are using the 9,099 amount of temperature, that much amount of temperature only we can use to melt the workpiece. And how many temperature remaining? For example, suppose here remaining the 50 degree temperature only remaining, and suppose the fire or flash point of your kerosene, it will be the 100, for example. It is not actual, but for example 100. Okay, what is the flash point of your kerosene is the 100 degree, and the now only how much temperature remaining here? 50 degree temperature is remaining, and we are knowing that at the 50 degree it is not burn. Okay, so that whatever kerosene we are using here, so that kerosene is not burn, because the large amount of temperature, whatever temperature is generated, out of that temperature, the most amount of temperature is only going to use to melt the workpiece, and small amount of temperature is remaining, and on that small amount of that, whatever the temperature is remaining, that temperature, it will be below the flash point. Okay, you have to remember to select the dielectrical fluid. Okay, to select the dielectrical fluid, we have to remember the flash point of your dielectrical fluid, it should be high. Okay, the flash point of your dielectrical fluid should be high. Okay, this is the simple electrical discharge machining. Okay, what is the application? This dielectrical discharge machining simple we can use to perform the it is used for the making the extrusion die, forging dies. Then also we can perform the internal threads in hard material. Then we can also perform the machining operation on the delicate workpiece like copper. Then also we can perform the resharpening of the cutting tool and broaches with the help of this WADM, and in the micro hole drilling is also possible with the help of this EDM. Okay, these are the simple basic application of the EDM. Then what is the advantages? With the help of this electrical discharge machining, we can perform the machining operation on any type of material, means whether that material it will be hard or that material it will be soft. Okay, the any complicated shape also we can machine or produce on the workpiece with the help of this WADM. So we are knowing that in the WADM there is no physical contact in between that workpiece and tool, so that there is no question of generating the residual traces. Okay, so there is no question of generating the traces into that workpiece. So the delicate workpiece also we can machine with the help of this EDM, and also very fine or precise hole also we can drill, and the surface finishing with this EDM is also obtained good. Okay, these are the simple advantages. Now see the disadvantages of EWM. The material removal rate is very slow. Then taper hole are produced, overcut is formed. Okay, you are understood the meaning of this overcut, means beyond the dimension. Okay, suppose it produces the component more than our requirement dimensions like this, then it cannot produce very sharp corners. Okay, and the wear of that tool, it will be maximum, and also it will take the large amount of power, means it will consume the large amount of power. And the main disadvantage is it is, or such type of the machining process we can use only for the conductive material. If that workpiece it will be non-conductive, then it is not possible to perform that EWM. Okay, now see, this is the second method, that is the WEDM, means wire cut electrical discharge machining. Okay, in that electrical discharge machining we are using the one rod as a tool, but in this method we are using one wire. Okay, see, okay, such type of the wire we are using as the tool. Okay, now same in this machining process, first upon I will tell you the construction, and then we will discuss the working principle. Here it consists of the workpiece. On that workpiece we want to perform the machining operation. Okay, and the another point is related to this machining process is such type of the machining process is used for to perform the line cutting simple. Okay, see, this is the workpiece. On that workpiece we want to perform the machining operation. Okay, then that workpiece is mounted on the table.
Okay, see, this is the table, and this table is moving, or the movement of that table is controlled with the help of the CNC machine. Okay, then here we are using, see, this is the wire. This wire is passed, or it is pulled through this workpiece. That wire is pulled through this workpiece, and it is wound with the help of the rollers are there. Okay, see, this is the roller, and again here in this wire electrical discharge machine also we are using the one battery, and here also we can use the DC supply. Okay, again same construction. The positive terminal of the battery, it is given to the workpiece, and the negative terminal of your battery is connected to the your wire. Okay, know that we are knowing that the wire we are using act as a, or here the wire, it will be act as a tool. Okay, and to the wire we have, to this wire we have connected the negative terminal, so that your wire is act as the cathode, and the positive terminal of your battery is connected to the workpiece, so that your workpiece act as the anode. Okay, basic. Now see the working principle. Fan, and here the some parameter you have to remember. The diameter of this wire, okay, the diameter of that wire, it will be 0.3 mm. Okay, that 0.3 mm diameter wire we have to use as the tool, and the material of that wire, okay, that material of that wire, it will be copper, or it will be tungsten. Okay, it will be the tungsten. And here in between this wire and workpiece there is also small amount of gap is also produced. Okay, in between this wire and workpiece also small amount of gap is produced, and that gap it will be 0.5 mm gap is used. And here also, okay, in this machining process also we are using the dielectrical fluid, and here we are knowing that electrical discharge machining we are using the kerosene as the dielectrical fluid, but in this method WDM we are using the water, distilled water we are using as the dielectric fluid. Okay, so this is the simple construction. Now see the working. Okay, when we are giving the supply, when we are giving the power supply, or that power supply is make on, that time what will happen? That time the small amount of, or we can say the small spark is generated. Okay, when we are giving the supply, that time the spark is generated in between this wire and workpiece. Okay, we are knowing that in between that wire and workpiece there is a small amount of gap is produced, and in that gap the spark is generated. Okay, here in one second we can say the 1000 number of spark is generated. Okay, in 1 second, I am talking about the 1 second. In 1 second here the 1000 of spark is generated in between this gap. Okay, now fan, and also here with the help of this pipe also we are here plus the dielectrical fluid on this gap. Okay, and fan, this spark, okay, when this spark is come in contact with the dielectrical fluid, that time what happen? Again same process it will happen. When that spark is come in contact with the dielectrical fluid, that time this dielectrical fluid is going to ionize. Okay, it is going to ionize, and it will supply the, or it will allow the flow, the current means through this gap current is going to flow. And when current is going to flow, that time the temperature between this gap, it is called as the spark gap. Okay, the temperature between that spark gap is going to increase, and that range of that temperature in between that spark, it will be the 10,000 degree to the 12,000 degree Celsius. That much amount of temperature is generated, and due to that temperature your workpiece is going to melt, and small amount of material is going to remove from that workpiece. Okay, on that principle again same, that wire electrical discharge machining is going to work. Okay, now see here application, that WDM we can use to produce the punch and dies. Okay, then for the production of the mold and dies. Okay, with the help of that WDM we can produce the mold and dies. Okay, also we can cut any complex shape.
Okay, any complex shape also we can generate on that conductive workpiece. And also we can perform the machining operation on cylindrical pin. Also we can perform the machining on the cylindrical pin whose diameter it will be 5 mm. After the 5 mm, we can also make the machining on a cylindrical pin. Then what is the advantages? What is the advantages of that WDM? Simple. The advantages of that WDM is the straight hole can be produced with close tolerance. Then high degree of accuracy and good surface finishing is obtained with the help of this WDM. Okay. Then very sharp angle cut is also possible, and the part also with the help of this WDM we can produce this part with the burr plate. Okay, means burr is not generated. That much amount of burr is not generated. Then disadvantages. Okay, we are knowing that in that wire electrical discharge machining, we are using the wire as the tool. Okay, and we are knowing that in between the spark gap, the large amount of spark is generated and large amount of temperature is also obtained. And because of that temperature, because of that high temperature, the whatever wire we are using in this machining process, that wire we can use only one time only. Okay, only once we can use this wire. Means we are not doing the reuse of that wire. This is the main disadvantages. Means for each operation we have to use the new wire. Then next point also we have to take into consideration, that is the next disadvantage, is the tension of wire. Whatever wire we are using for the as a tool, the tension of that wire we have to maintain, because on that tension of your wire the surface finishing is depend. Okay, for this process generally we have to use 50 to 60% tension of your tensile strength. Okay, 50 to 60% tension we have to generate in the wire with their tensile strength. That much amount of tension should be there inside the wire. Okay, suppose this is the wire and the tension of this wire, it will be 50 to 60% of here of its tensile strength. That much amount of tension should be there. Then and then only it will produce the good surface finishing. Otherwise, it will produce the poor surface finishing. And this, okay, then again, same disadvantages. Again, this WDM is applicable only for the conductive material. If there is the non-conductive material, then it is impossible to perform the machining operation because it does not show the curve. Okay, this is about the two methods. Okay, so some parameter you have to remember here. That parameter I will explain here regarding to that both the process. Share in that electrical discharge machining. Okay, for the electrical discharge machining. Okay, tell me which type of dielectrical fluid we can use. Okay, you have to remember for this machining process we can use here kerosene as a dielectrical fluid. Okay, kerosene we can use as the dielectrical fluid. Then we have to require to maintain the small amount of the gap. Okay, small amount of the gap we should maintain in between the tool and workpiece, and that gap is called as the spark gap. Okay, that point also you have to remember. We are maintaining the small distance, small gap is maintaining between the tool and workpiece, and that gap is called as the spark gap. Is called as the spark gap, and that spark gap it will vary from the 0.01 mm to the 0.5 mm. Okay, then we have to remember, after the ionization process after flowing the current in the electrical discharge machining, the large amount of current is generated. Okay, what is the range of that current? Nearly about 10,000. Okay, 10,000 degree Celsius to the 12,000 degree Celsius. That much amount of current is generated. Okay, that point you have to remember. The next point also you have to remember. So whatever that tool we are using, whatever the rod as a tool we are using, what is the material of this tool? What is the material of that tool? The material of that tool, it will be. The material of your tool, it will be copper, it will be the brass or aluminium. Okay, that point you have to remember. Again, the important point is Okay, there are the different or number of dielectrical fluids are there. Okay, what are the dielectrical fluids are there? We can use the transformer oil as a dielectrical fluid. Transformer oil. Then also we can use the lubricating oil as the dielectrical fluid. Also we can use the kerosene as a dielectric fluid. Also we can use the distilled water as a dielectrical fluid. Okay. And what is the function of that dielectrical fluid? What is the function of that dielectrical fluid? That dielectrical fluid, it will produces two main functions. Okay. What is the function of that dielectrical fluid? Yes. Yes. The dielectrical fluid, it will act as the insulator at the initially. I'm talking about the function of your dielectrical fluid. Okay, the function of that first function of your dielectric fluid is it at initially. At initially, it will act as the insulator. Means at the initially, it does not flow the current. Means at the initially, it will act as the insulator. And then once your required temperature or once your required voltage is reached, at that time it will act as the conductor. Okay, it will act as the conductor. And also the next function of your dielectric fluid is it will cool. The dielectric fluid also cool that tool and workpiece. Okay, also cool the tool and workpiece. These are the basic function of your dielectric fluid. Then what is the property should be required for the dielectric fluid? Your dielectric fluid, it should have high flash point. Okay, your flash point should be high. Okay. Okay. This is about the electrical discharge machine. Then, similar manner, also you have to remember here some parameters for this WDM. Okay. What are the parameter for this? First parameter. What is the diameter of this wire? Okay. In that WDM, we are using the wire as the tool. Okay, wire as the tool. And what is the diameter of that wire? Okay, the wire diameter is equal to, it will be the 0.3 mm. It will be the 0.3 mm. Then, what is the material of this wire? What is the material of this wire? The material of this wire, it will be copper. Okay, or tungsten. Understand? Then here for this WDM, what we have to use the dielectrical fluid as a distilled water. We have used as a dielectrical fluid water. Distilled water we can use as a dielectrical fluid. And also, what will be the gap between this tool and workpiece? Means what will be the gap between this wire and this workpiece? And that gap is called as again same. It is called as the spark gap. Okay, it is called as the spark gap, and that spark gap, it will be 0.5 mm. Okay, 0.5 mm. Okay, and both the process that electrical discharge machining and wire electrical discharge machining, both the machining process are only useful for the conductive materials. Okay, if the material, if your workpiece, it will be not conductive, then again it is not possible. Okay, and the material removing rate is also less for that process. Okay, this is about the both the process. Okay, so anybody having any problem, any doubt is there, you can ask. So anybody having any problem, any doubt?
No problem, sir.